ready. Hey, welcome to Go Rio San Antonio Cruises. Please remain seated at all times. Please keep everything, eyes, ears, nose, mouth extensions, big kids like me, and little kids inside. Inside the handrail. No tobacco products, including e-cigarettes. And we do have enough life jackets on board for everybody should we need them. However, we have never used them. We've never needed them. Please, no talking on your cell phones during the charter. Respect for other guests. No reaching up and touching the low-lying bridges. If you talk, talk very, very quietly so all others may hear the tour. My name's David. We'll be together about 30, 35 minutes, 2.5 miles. If you have any questions, please keep them to yourself. Feel free to ask me. Right above us here is the Robert Hugman Bridge, completed in 1941. However, we like to call this our Selena Bridge. Back in 1997, they produced the Selena movie here. Jennifer Lopez was the star. This bridge and Jennifer were in the movie. When they completed the movie, the bridge stayed. Jennifer made her money. Hey, if you would like one of the best pictures on the Riverwalk, you may turn around and take a picture of me and the Selena Bridge. Yeehaw! Hey, continuing the tour here on my left is the Omni, La Mancio, Del Rio Hotel. Back in 1853, this was St. Mary's All Boys. It evolved into the St. Mary's School of Law down through the campus into the west part of San Antonio. Just opened at the hotel in 1888. The foyer of this hotel is a part of the original 1853 structure. Be ready and eager to enjoy the view underneath this bridge. You look directly to my left and straight up. Directly to my left and straight up and an optical illusion. Good to come underneath the bridge here. That's what appears to be a freestanding wall. This is the Dix Hospital, opened in 1930 at San Antonio's very first full-service hospital. First hospital in the United States of America to have central air conditioning. 89 years later, still a full-service hospital, offering services from band-aids to surgery. If you recognize the name Carol Burnett, she was born in the Dix Hospital. Directly in front of the boat here is the Hyatt Regency Hotel, opened in 1981. However, before they could begin construction at the new shadow testing, they did not want to cast a shadow on the Alamo at sunset. Thus, the testing was done. They limited this hotel to 16 stories. So now the sun is shining as it is today. It says daily on the sacred Alamo. And coming around the bend on my left, above the glass doors at the Hyatt Regency Hotel, you're going to notice that it says the Shots of Paseo del Alamo, which means passageway to the Alamo. It's a beautiful atrium with waterfalls, mountains, trees, and plants. You go straight to this atrium, right across the street, takes you directly to the Alamo Square and the Alamo Museum. We're about 70 yards from the Alamo.
The Shots of Paseo del Alamo. Like an Alamo? De verdad se les recomiendo, es un lugar muy lindo.
On the right side of the boat here, the six-story red brick building is the Casino Club, opened in 1927 as a private club built by the German business community.
El edificio que está al pasar.
Today, the bottom two floors of the Casino Club here on my right side house restaurants and shops. The top four floors are apartments, and you're more than welcome to rent one if you don't mind being on a six-year waiting list. This part of the river here is called River Square, renovated in 1972. Here we have a variety of restaurants that offer inside and riverside dining. I have dinner on one of our boats. You can check the website on your ticket stub or ask it at one of our ticket counters. All along the river here, we have lots of ducks. Lots and lots of ducks. They're here year-round and they eat lots and lots of food. But that's okay, folks, everything they eat, we put it on their bill.
my wife do is waiting for me to grow up. But if I do, how'd you know?
Él dice que su esposa espera que él crezca, pero él no quiere crecer porque no quiere estar viejo.
As we go by the balcony, you'll see the name Robert Huggman. He was the architect of the Riverwalk, the first one to have an office on my right side at the completion of the park in 1941.
Continuamos ahorita en el próximo video. Recuerda compartirlo y darle te gusta y suscribirte a mi canal. Espero que siempre disfrutes de mis aventuras.